Come, please sit down. Miss Fatima, you are one of the rare Muslim girls who have appeared for these interviews. Why is it that more Muslim girls and less, I would be very happy if more Muslim girls come and join these services. Why not? Why are they not coming forward?
Sir, there are several factors, and I think one of the biggest reason could be the general backwardness that our community faces in India. So there is also an element of high-reaching patriarchy that exists in Muslim societies all over the country, and that sort of prevents more girls from coming up, sir.
But does patriarchy affect educated families also? Affluent, educated Muslim family? I don't think so. They are forward.
Yes. But some elements still do remain, I feel.
Okay.
Sir.
Miss Fatima, since foreign service is your first preference, Donald Trump had recently announced a West Asia peace plan relating to Palestine and Israel. What were the highlights of that?
From what I've read, I've seen that Donald Trump has said that it is basically that talks should begin between Palestine and Israel, leaders of both. So one of the major highlights with that is the thing regarding Jerusalem itself. So we've seen that earlier Trump's administration had taken major moves such as recognizing Jerusalem.
Yeah, but just tell me briefly, what is it that, what are 1, 2, 3
sure.
which he has recommended, and why has Palestine rejected it outright?
Sure, sir. And I feel the second one taken was recognition.
One is Jerusalem.
Jerusalem,
they have not been given anything in Jerusalem, right?
Yes.
What is the second?
Second one is recognition of hitherto occupied territories, which have been
West Bank. That is
for
second.
Israel. And
right.
Return.
And one more. Yes, return of?
Return of
refugees. These are the three things on which. Which means the Palestine is saying, you've given everything to Israel, nothing has been given to us, right? So, that is the reason why they are not happy with that. Now, you remember this, the US had come out with a policy called CATSA, countering America's adversaries. And we were impacted on two counts. One was our imports of oil from Iran, and the other was buying defense equipment from Russia. Now, is that ban still applicable to us or not?
Sir, we see that CATSA is one of the tools of sort of arm twisting tactic which is used by USA. So, I think though the CATSA was imposed by USA, India sort of took a balancing act and we continued to purchase oil and S-400 Triumph.
But they have given us a window of 6 months,
yes,
isn't it?
Yes, sir.
That window lapsed in November last year, I think, November 2019. After that, is that CATSA still in vogue or not?
I'm not sure about its status.
Good. Okay, now, have you heard of the scheme called Udaan?
Yes.
This regional connectivity scheme.
Yes.
What does it say?
Sir, regional Ude Desh Ka Am Nagrik.
Yeah.
That scheme was started in order to improve regional connectivity. And
right.
We see that as per the scheme, there are a few sub-schemes that come under it. There's a fund in order to improve the existing infrastructure, and there is a scheme to put a cap on flight prices. To make it more accessible to a lot of people, especially in tier 2 cities.
So in this budget which has just come out, has there been any reference to Udaan?
I'm sorry, sir.
And there is. They have said that in the next so many years, 100 more airports would be added.
I'll go read up, sir.
Right. Now, what is this electoral bonds? Can you tell me something about that?
Yes, sir. So, electoral bonds were introduced with the aim of streamlining election funding.
Yeah.
So, here they have been divided into certain numbers starting from 10,000 onwards up to 1 lakh. 1 crore. And here we have to fill in KYC norms, which sort of...
No, that is all right. What I'm asking is that why has it come under criticism by some groups? You know, they moved to Supreme Court.
So I think one of the reasons for criticism is how it considers foreign funding. It some certain changes have been made so as to ensure funds from outside can come in. And then it is not as transparent as it may seem.
Thank you.
Hello, Mohisa. As a student of economics, I would like to have your honest take. Has this budget done enough to pump prime the economy, which is on a slowdown mode?
Okay, sir. Sir, may I explain using certain...
Sure.
So, one of the first things that came into my mind with regards to pump priming would be that the importance government has given to infrastructure. So we have seen 100% waiver of tax of sovereign funds coming from outside. So we can sort of pool in investment from Temasek Holdings and which is of Singapore and Malaysia, and certain funding can come in which can improve the infrastructure and help India come up to you know, the $5 trillion economy. The second one, if I remember correctly, is with regards to the income tax, and there's a new optional personal income tax, this thing. So I think it benefits the middle income and lower middle income categories, and that can boost demand, consumer demand especially. With regards to other things, I feel that our budget may have fallen short on certain areas, such as improving rural demand, because we see that a lot of existing schemes have huge delay in payments of wages, etc.
Thank you. Excellent. Now, President Trump would be visiting India shortly. What do you think would be on the table when in Hyderabad House our Prime Minister and President Trump sit across the table?
So I think it can bring a lot of positives with regards to our MOU between the two nations with for economic deals. We can see perhaps a lot of new investment coming in.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, I think on the geopolitical front, with regards to ongoing issues, with regards to Kashmir, USA had earlier offered that they might want to negotiate. So that could be a point of contention there. And thirdly, I feel that since...
That has been ruled out by India categorically, that we don't want any mediation.
Yes.
So that's not going to be discussed. But be more specific, what are the irritants in Indo-US relations?
Sir, I feel...
About trade.
Sure, sir. Earlier the US government had withdrawn the GSP or the Generalized System of Preferences,
right,
which was offered to developing countries. So that was taken away, and that affects our relationship. Secondly, with regards to WTO norms, we see that USA has made certain moves which sort of affects, such as blocking the appointment for dispute redressal committee.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a thorn in the relationship and affects countries like India, where, you know, we are still upcoming on the trade front. And thirdly, I would say that there is still that element of taxes and countervailing taxes. Donald Trump, the president, called us tariff king with regards to Harley-Davidson issue. So I think all of these would remain there.
You have been an NSS volunteer.
Yes.
What is the motto of NSS?
The motto is not me but you.
Okay. So you were a volunteer of NSS at college level or school level?
At college level.
Now it's been extended to schools also, secondary schools.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
You're from Kerala. It's also known as God's own country.
Yes.
Why is that so?
Ma'am, when we look at it, there are multiple elements that contribute into the term or the tagline. When we look at it geographically, we are, Kerala is a thin strip of land straddled between a long coastline and a long mountainous range. And we have different kinds of geographical land. Secondly would be the social element and the intermingling of various religious cultures. We know that Islam and Christianity sort of came into India through Kerala. That is there. And thirdly is the current, the presence of multiple religions and the harmony that still exists. On a same road, the place where I was studying in Palayam, temples and
all others. Since you talked about temples, ban on women entering places of religious worship. What are your views on that? Because we have the Sabarimala, yes, which is there. Then now lots of women, Muslim women banned from entering the mosques, which was not there earlier. So why is that happening now?
Ma'am, in my opinion, all places of worship, regardless of religion, should be made open to women. So
why?
The reason, at the end of the day, my take is that religion does not exist in silos. That is, whatever happens in religion sort of trickles down into the social space and it affects how people in general view women. So making something Sabarimala, as iconic as Sabarimala or even the biggest mosque open for women, it sends a message across to the general public.
Regarding equality of sexes.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, Kerala was affected by cyclone and floods 2 years back. So was there any government agency which looked into this disaster?
Yes, ma'am. There were a few committees that were constructed.
Do we have any agency which looks specially after disasters in India?
Are you referring to the disaster management part, ma'am?
Yes,
or
disaster management.
I think it's the NDMA, National Disaster Management.
So what are the different types of disasters which can take place in our country?
Ma'am, when we look at the present scenario, according to the IPCC report, fifth assessment report, India is second most prone to climate change.
You just mentioned the types of disasters.
Sure, ma'am.
Both man-made and environment.
Okay, ma'am.
Naturally.
So when we look at natural disasters, we are at an all-time risk of climate change related events,
mm-hmm,
such as floods, droughts,
yes,
heat waves, etc. On the man-made front, we have certain landslides occurring due to encroachment which is taking place. For example, it happened in Kerala.
Okay.
And forest fires to some extent man-made as well as natural.
Mm-hmm. So you talked of climate change. Why is climate change becoming such an important issue?
Ma'am, all over the world, climate change is something that is affecting, and we are seeing day-to-day elements of that happening. In Australia, we have the bushfires, which is,
yes,
still continuing. In Australia itself, on a certain section of the country, there are flash floods. And we have severe droughts that are we face. By 2040, it is estimated that almost all of India will not have access to clean drinking water. And there are several, the Amazon fires that took place. And then there is an overall increase in temperature. So all of these are sort of pushing us to the limits of how much Earth can take.
So now we would say that climate change is one of the global concerns that all of us have.
Yes.
Can you name any one or two or three other concerns, global concerns? Just name them.
Sure, ma'am. The second one would be the growing inequality.
Okay, inequality. Then just name it. Third, fourth, whatever you can think of.
Third one would be a rising tendency of extreme nationalism,
okay,
and inward looking strategies. Fourth one would be our failure to meet sustainable development goals in countries. And then
terrorism, money laundering, and the most important now, pandemics.
Pandemics.
So, thank you.
Thank you for reminding me.
Ms. Fatima, you have done economics and you aspire to be an Indian Foreign Service officer. This year, the United Nations would be 75 years old. Can you tell us one or two objectives as enshrined in its charter? And some of the achievements or failures to achieve those objectives.
So we see that when you look into history, the United Nations came into force right after the World War. So as by virtue of that itself, we see their main intention was to maintain global peace and harmony. And the second one was to ensure universal human rights and global cooperation to reach sustainable development goals. When we look at its successes, we see that its arms, such as the United Nations Peacekeeping Force, has been truly instrumental in preventing a lot of problems, in especially in African nations. On the same side, the Rwandan genocide between the Hutu-Tutsi tribes were seen to be one of the biggest red flags which the United Nations failed to counter. Again, on the positives, its UN's fellow organizations such as World Health Organization have done tremendous contribution all over the world.
Thank you. Just to clarify that UN peacekeeping is not for establishing peace.
Yes.
The UN peacekeepers go after peace has been established. And fellows, you can mention, of course, that in the Middle East and some other parts,
yes,
they have been able, not been able to prevent conflicts.
Thank you, sir.
Can you just tell me what are the major areas of disputes with China in terms of our territorial disputes?
In terms of territorial disputes, when we look at the border, in different sectors we have some issues. On the northern sector, the Aksai Chin line of actual control is still there. And then in the middle sector, near Bhutan, there's the Doklam affair. And then there is China's, on the eastern side, there is Chinese occupation of Arunachal Pradesh and them wanting Tawang and asking for that is
the claims
on Tawang.
Okay. Now, you would have noticed that the exports have not been doing very well, and the ratio of exports to GDP has been declining for the past 5-6 years. What could be the reasons for being declining?
The reasons that I believe are as follows. One is the global shrinking in trade itself. So Kristalina Georgieva, has the head of IMF, had said that global trade has shrunk by almost 1 to 1.5%. Second one would be India's failure as with regards to logistical improvement. Though we have made a lot of good changes in our foreign policy documents, we still fall behind with regards to logistics, and that is one of the single biggest reasons why our exports fall back. Third reason is compared to our global competitors such as China, we fall behind in manufacturing, and the growth of certain tools which are useful for exports, such as special economic zones compared to China's.
Good. You could perhaps also add that these small and medium industries, which were the backbone of our exports, are not doing so well now. Thank you.
What is India's position in the Human Development Index?
I don't know, sir. I'll find out.
Very poor. 130 out of 189 countries. All right. You read fiction. What is any recent books which you may have read?
With regards to recent, I've read a few books, but they're not really.
Name fiction. Some good book which you have read.
Sure, sir. Reread Marquez's 100 Years of Solitude, The Handmaid's Tale by Margaret Atwood, Moss, which
no,
is a.
Name one. I'll ask questions on that.
Okay, sir. 100 Years of
which
Solitude.
Has impressed you, which you liked a lot.
Moss series 1 and 2 by Art Spiegelman. It is about Art Spiegelman.
Who is he? From which country?
So he is currently lives as an immigrant in the USA, and his father was a director.
So what does he write about?
He writes about war, the World Wars specifically.
World Wars.
He was a German. And he writes first-hand account of Spiegelman.
So this book which you read,
yes,
what is the theme?
So the overarching theme is about war and how it affects the human psyche and how episodes such as the Holocaust affected people.
So is this based on factual events or just fiction?
Factual events, but fictionalized.
This particular book is based on World War II incidents or World War I?
World War II incidents.
What was the theater about?
Yeah.
Which theater?
The theater was Europe, and he was a Jew actually.
Uh-huh.
So his father had to spend some time in the internment camps in Auschwitz.
Where was Auschwitz?
Auschwitz is in Poland.
Poland, yes, quite right. Okay. Now, you are fond of tea tasting.
Yes.
What is so important about tea tasting that you have given it as a hobby?
Sir, it all started because tea is a good companion to reading. And it was, and slowly I started to look at healthier alternatives. And what inspired me a lot was the wonderful history tea itself had. And
right.
then I
good,
looked
good.
At...
Got it, got it. Now, what is India's ranking among the tea exporters?
Currently number 2.
Number 2. How much do we export and what foreign exchange we earn?
There is... I believe we earn about $900 million.
Only?
Yes.
What a small thing. Not even 1 billion?
Mm-hmm.
And who is number 1? Sri Lanka?
China.
China is number 1. Now, which are the best brands which we are selling and to which countries? Exclusive brands.
So, more than a single brand, the Darjeeling tea and Assam tea are global, world famous, which are teas from India.
Uh-huh.
And they have a huge market. Even
does Kerala also grow tea?
Yes, sir.
It
do.
Grows.
Yes, sir. Kerala.
Is it known more for coffee or for tea?
I would say tea a little bit more than coffee, sir. Nilgiri
what
is, tea is
has famous. The forest cover in Kerala increased or decreased in the last 2 years?
Last 2 years, I'm not sure, sir.
Okay, you're not sure. Now, a few blocks were demolished in Kochi, I think.
Yes, sir.
Are you think it was the right thing to demolish them, or we could have used them without degrading the environment? Why we had to demolish them? After all, they were built.
Yes.
So much money was there.
Yes.
Only thing was that if people had started living there, it would have polluted the whole place and dirtied the environment. Supposing we had allowed them to continue, what is your view on this? Would be.
Sir, I think the Marada demolition which took place goes beyond the act of demolition of the 4 flats itself. Kerala, we see there are around 26,000 CRZ.
So what you're saying is, it was Supreme Court, was it?
Yes, Supreme Court.
Was giving a, delivering a, Deli- a
message.
Message
also.
Yes,
sir.
Deterrence.
Yes, sir. Deterrence.
Correct. Now, Foreign Service is your first choice. What are the objectives of India's foreign policy? Name 1, 2, 3 most important in that order. There are several, but I would like you to name the 3 most important in that order. What it is trying to achieve. Yes, take your time. And
may I start?
Yes.
So I think the first one would be to project India's image to the global population. That is, we are going to have an Asian century, and it is time that India assert itself and show what
okay,
we are truly
right.
capable
be
of.
Be brief. One is that you want to project India's image. Mm-hmm. Second?
Second one is to promote India's self-interest with regards to economics and geopolitical aspects.
What else?
Third one would be to protect the needs of the Indian population in India as well as the rest
okay,
of the world.
Okay, okay. I'm asking one last question.
Yes.
Have you heard of Democracy Index? Did I ask you a question on this? No.
Yes,
have you heard of Democracy
yes.
Index, which
yes.
was brought out by the Economic
yes.
Intelligence Unit?
Yes, sir.
Where does it place India? Latest?
Sir, I know that our ranking has fallen, but I'm not sure.
How much it has fallen?
I don't know,
sir. Terrible. 58 to 68. So, all right. One more question. Indo-Pacific region. America and India have different perception of what is this Indo-Pacific. What is the difference?
We see, when we look at USA's perspective, we see that they
no,
have...
No, it's about the territory, the
territory.
Reach. What is...
The reach.
What defines the geographical limits?
Yes. I think both sides agree on the fact that it starts from western side of the Indian Ocean. And then it spreads. India feels that it goes
okay.
until Japan
right,
and for
right.
USA.
All right, all right. We close the interview. Now I'll give you a little feedback. You've performed well, Ms. Fatima. Some areas are there where you need to focus more attention. Time is very short now for you, just
yes.
about 10 to 12 days.
Yes.
First is you're looking everywhere while answering. My colleague was asking you a question and you were looking at me, you were looking here. This is what other interview, you know, training people, training institution, they keep saying that you look everywhere, otherwise so-and-so will feel offended, so-and-so will feel offended. Don't do that.
Okay.
Maintain eye contact with the person who is asking you questions.
Okay.
There are 5 members in the interview board. Each one is assessing independently in his own way. So they are watching you all the time. You don't have to tell them that, look, I am also there. Okay, they are watching you.
Okay,
they are watching everything that you are saying, every gesture you are making. So if I am asking a question, maintain contact with me. Otherwise, it is not practicable to go on looking from there to there all the time. See? And then I'll feel offended that, look, I am asking a question and you look there. Don't do it.
Yes,
practice
it is
from
true
today.
That I got other views.
Practices from today. And second is objectives. You should be very clear. After all, foreign service, image, etc. is okay. The first thing is our security and territorial integrity. The very basic requirement. Second is economic development. Right? And third, after we have satisfied this, then we want to project image. We are looking for seat in a union council, diaspora, and all that, you know. So go for the basics instead of talk other things. Then you were asked question, this major disputes with China.
Yes,
you could have said a lot of things.
Yes, sir.
It is blocking us in energy.
Then
what is the terror? Masood Azhar? They're blocking there. Everywhere they block us.
Yes.
They brought out Kashmir unnecessarily,
yes,
when everyone was supporting us. So they, and then in Indo-Pacific is the most serious thing, where they are making inroads. We are worried about there. So you could have given a much more effective answer.
But Masood Azhar was finally declared as a terrorist last year,
in
spite of China.
Yeah, you're right.
But they withdrew.
Yes, sir.
Then it's over. Then it's on. Then fine. Absolutely right. Absolutely right. And these, then 2 more things which I suggest. One is economics is your subject. So some questions can be expected of India's economy, and then what is the budget doing? Indo-Pacific is the basic difference. India regards Indo-Pacific, it starts from Pacific, you know, from that Siberia side and Vladivostok, all the way, or from America, all the way up to the West Asia. America feels it stops at our western coast. They are not paying much attention to the Arabian Sea part.
Yes.
So that is the difference. All right. So we close the interview. This is how I feel. And Kerala, I have asked you a number of questions. You have to prepare yourself well. Kerala is considered the highest in, you know, Human Development Index, education, etc. So uspe aap zara sa kariye to aapke strong points hai.
Would I ask you a question on Nipah virus, how Kerala dealt with Nipah virus in the context of coronavirus?
Calamity, you know, state calamity.
All the best.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.